Cases continue to spread in urban and rural areas, and some officials fear the U.S. still does not have a grasp on the pandemic. Most states are seeing a week-over-week rise in test positivity rates for COVID-19. That is a strong indicator of how the virus is spreading. The CDC's new forecast predicts nearly 20,000 more COVID-related deaths by August 22nd. That breaks down to close to 1,000 deaths per day between now and then. Joining us now to talk about this is the nation's top infectious disease expert, Dr. Anthony Fauci. Thank you for being with us.
Good to be with you. Thank you for having me.
I know everyone has been hearing you talk about this vaccine possibly by the end of 2020. Is that the timetable, and how effective is it? Because it only has to be about 50% effective, so it's not like a measles vaccine that we might expect, correct?
Well, we do not know how effective it is, and that's the entire purpose of doing a phase three trial. Two particular candidates started in a phase three trial last week on July 27th. It will take about 3 months to enroll them, about 30,000 people in the trial. 15,000 will get the vaccine and 15,000 will get placebo. The critical issue is that we don't know if it's safe and effective now, and that's the reason why you do the clinical trial. And we hope, and I'm pretty confident, that this will be able to, I would say, by the end of the year, which I've been saying, we will know whether it's safe and effective. We're cautiously optimistic that it will be, because the earliest studies that we did in the phase one showed that in a limited number of people, that it induced the kind of response, namely a good neutralizing antibody response, which is the gold standard of the thing you would expect would protect you. It induces it at levels that are equivalent to, if not even better, than what happens when you recover from natural infection that you get in convalescent serum. So that's a very good sign. So although there's no guarantee until you complete the trial to show it's effective, which is the reason why you do a trial, hopefully by the end of the year, we'll have that answer to that question, and vaccine will be made available to people as we get into 2021 or the end of 2020.
Some of the feedback you get from people when they talk about these trials are the worry that the vaccine is being rushed too quickly and there's not enough time to find out about possible side effects of the vaccine. Is there enough time for that with this particular trial and how we're going with this?
Yes, we believe so. The speed that we're doing vaccine is not at the compromising of safety, nor is it compromising scientific integrity. It's using modern day technologies to cut time away that doesn't really compromise the kinds of things that are important to the trial. For example, from the time we got the sequence of the virus that was put on a public database to the time we went into phase one was measured in a few months. Normally, that would take well over a year. And yet there was nothing compromising safety about that. It was merely a technical capability of getting the vaccine to be ready to test in people. So we're very sensitive to the concept of making sure we want to make it safe and we want to prove that it's effective. And that's what the ultimate phase three trial results are all about, that we hopefully will be able to get that to the American people by the end of the year, the beginning of 2021.
So, Dr. Fauci, there's a significant portion of the population that still does not believe they need to wear masks. There's lots of videos that have gone viral that have since been discredited. What do you say to those people who think this is really not that serious of an issue?
Well, you just have to look at the numbers. 154,000 people have died, well over 4 million infections in our own country. Clearly, this is a very serious issue. And you know, even though statistically, younger people do much better in the sense of have a much less likelihood of serious disease, we're seeing more and more that young people are getting sick with this and are getting significant consequences. Again, not nearly as much as the elderly and those with underlying conditions, but this is not a trivial disease to be taken lightly. And we're starting to see that even people who don't go to the hospital, that maybe have to stay home for several days or even weeks in a row, that they have lingering symptoms that can last for a considerable period of time. So please, we should not be taking this disease lightly. It is historic in its proportions. We need to take it seriously.
Dr. Fauci, we appreciate you joining us this morning. If you would like to enroll in the vaccine trials, you can go to coronaviruspreventionnetwork.org. Thank you.